are going to check in with Jim Renacci, also a Republican, and we thank you for being with us this morning. We know this is just a very scary, terrifying time right now for our nation, and especially you serving the Ohio area and knowing this is one of your own. Thank you for being with us, and what can you tell us this morning?
Well, thank you, and what a tragic morning this is. You know, when I learned, and my thoughts and prayers are with Steve Scalise, a friend of mine. This was a baseball practice, a bipartisan. We have a bipartisan charity event that it goes on tomorrow, where Republicans and Democrats play in a charity event to raise money. The Republicans were practicing at one field, which they do every morning. The Democrats were practicing at a field a couple blocks away. From what I understand, one of my colleagues, an individual, walked up and said, "Is this the Republican practice?" And they said it was, and they were leaving. And this individual walked down and started shooting at members. But there were also, the sad thing was, there were members, there were staff, and there were lobbyists there. Thank goodness that Steve Scalise has the security detail. Yes. Steve Scalise is the whip, so he's one of the three top in leadership in the Republican Party. He had two members of security detail there who returned fire. Steve Scalise was hit. The two security details were also hit. They did return fire. It's my understanding. At first, I did not hear. I know they brought their gunman down, but I understand they killed him. Others were hit. One of the lobbyists that was standing near the first base side was actually hit in the chest. Mm-hmm. So six people were taken to the hospital, and we continue to keep them all in our thoughts and prayers.
Now, you're hearing that the gunman was actually shot and killed, Congressman?
Yeah, I was told by one person that was at the practice that he was shot and brought down. Then I was also told that, no, he was shot and killed. But he was taken to the hospital as well.
Talk about, you know, it's unfortunately these sad, sick events that then change the course of how you guys live. And then now we're going to probably see, you know, hopefully this will continue, this bipartisan great event that brings all of you together away from talking politics, and something that's been a long-standing tradition for so many years in Washington, D.C., that you all look forward to. And it's kind of a way to kind of lighten the mood. Talk about how now has really cast just a dark cloud over events like this that you guys still kind of hang on to.
Well, absolutely, Stephanie. And you know what was interesting? This morning was my bipartisan breakfast. I've had since I came to Congress 7 years ago, I started a bipartisan working breakfast with other members from both sides. And this morning was actually the breakfast. And what we were talking about was how this will bring us together, only for a few days later to take us apart again. Mm-hmm. And that's the sad thing about Washington. Look, our problems aren't Republican problems. They're not Democrat problems. They're American problems. I say it all the time. We have to be able to work together. The American people are frustrated that partisanship has become so evident down here, and things don't get done because of partisanship. And this is this event that we have, this baseball event, is one of those things that's bipartisan. It's a good charity event, and there will be a dark cloud over it tomorrow night. But what's even worse, as we said this morning in the breakfast, that 3 or 4 days from now, the partisanship will come back. And that's the sad thing. It's very frustrating for me. It's very frustrating for a lot of members down here, realizing how partisan and divided we are.
Congressman, when you think about the fact that this could have been a targeted attack at Republicans, what does it say to you as far as the divisiveness that's evident in this nation?
Well, Wayne, one thing I've learned when I got elected, you know, one of my first town halls was right after the Gabby Gifford shooting. Mm. And I had to continue to always, it's an eerie feeling when you're a member of Congress because you don't have security around you, so you're always looking. I've never had to look over my shoulder as much as I do now.
Yes.
That I'm a member of Congress. I've never had to be more aware of my environment. I've never had to be more cautious of my environment. I've never had to worry about places that I walk into as much as I do today. And that's a part of being a member of Congress.
Yeah.
It's sad,
yeah.
But
mm-hmm.
It's that partisanship and that divisiveness that we have. And look, I say this all the time. It's not going to get fixed down here. It has to get fixed back home. And that's why when I'm back in Ohio, I talk about ways that we have to be able to work together. We may disagree, but at the same time, there are a lot of things we can agree on, and we have to be able to work together to do that.
Is it time to tone down the rhetoric on both sides?
There is too much rhetoric, and I think that rhetoric has to be toned down. And I think in the end, what we have to start doing is realizing that we're all American people. We're all on this in this great country for a reason, and we may disagree, but we can agree to disagree. Look, I have just as many friends on the Democrat side as I have on the Republican side. I can walk into the Democrat club down here and be welcome just as much as I can bring Democrats into the Republican club. It's sad that we have a Republican and Democrat club here, but that's the divisiveness of what we have down here. And I can tell you it's something that I'm not used to, because in my business career of 30 years, I didn't care whether you're Republican, Democrat, Independent, Socialist. I didn't really care. It was all about getting the job done for the people that we either worked for or represented. And that should be the real key.
Sure, and it seems that some of these issues are just such hot-button issues that people are very passionate about, and it goes just beyond the debating, and then people take it to a whole new level.
Absolutely.
And we're seeing that unfold all across our nation, and especially this morning. We thank you for being with us, Congressman Renacci. We really appreciate your time this morning.
Well, thank you both.
Thank you.